Thank you, Mr. President. I would like to speak on item K and also H. Specifically, I want to thank Councilmember Friedson and Reamer, as well as staff from the executive, specifically HHS, in this whirlwind attempt at combining actually two special appropriations. And I do want to say to my colleagues that, you know, we have, I think, very nicely worked very collaboratively on all of these particular special appropriations. This one in particular, we were literally until yesterday super late finalizing a lot of the details. If not, obviously we would have circulated it to all of you, because I know that all of you care so much about early care and education, specifically childcare. But this definitely is, you know, an attempt to give a shot, you know, shot in the arm to our childcare sector. As we are discussing reopening the county, of course, you know, having access to quality, affordable, geographically accessible childcare is going to be a key component. Can only imagine the stress that parents are actually experiencing as things begin to reopen and they have to go back to work, and the notion that maybe your childcare arrangement is no longer there. And so to not only deal with the stress of children being at home all this time, but then having to make a change in your childcare arrangement, it's something that I know personally is extraordinarily stressful. So what we're doing here, again, we're combining the special appropriation that the county executive has sent over with our own, and it's pretty straightforward. I mean, it provides funds for childcare, both centers and family childcare programs, to be able to address losses, but also to be able to have operating funds for at least a month, as well as funds for them to be COVID-19 ready in terms of things like PPE, or if you have to rearrange of, you know, different kinds of obviously techniques that you need to implement in order to be safe and provide that kind of safe care. And so it is a total of $10 million. We do know that there are $2 million in the early care and education initiatives budget that will also be used for this effort. So in total is $12 million. And again, I want to thank staff who worked so hard. I want to thank Berta Sosimo from my office, who worked really hard with Vivian Yao, as well as Rose from Councilmember Friedson's office, and Ken Silverman as well, and everybody who just really quickly merged these two particular special appropriations. So thank you so much for that. I did want to also point out that we have 3H, which is a release of four papers. These are recovery outlook papers from the Office of Legislative Oversight. As you recall, we it was something that I felt very strongly and proposed to all of you for support, to have our Office of Legislative Oversight begin to produce, to publish papers on recovery. In other words, so that we can all have in-depth information about what this means as we reopen, as we recover. What does this all mean for our county? And they have just released office and industrial commercial real estate, telework and economic development, public transit in a pandemic environment, and commercial real estate hospitality sector. So these papers will hopefully guide all of us in these particular areas as we are now looking at and seeking reopening in a gradual manner.